Welcome to our 2020 driver test. But before we get started, here's a behind the scenes view of how we've actually done it. As you can see, we put a lot of effort into creating these videos and producing the data which gives us the most insightful tests and reviews that we can. We've been testing all of the new 2020 drivers now for a good number of weeks and over a number of different days as well, Neil, and you've really enjoyed them.
Yeah, it's been probably the most enjoyable video that we've done. Testing all the new drivers. Everybody loves smashing drivers, don't they? It's great fun. So yeah, and also a few surprises in there, what performed well and what didn't perform too well. So I'm really looking forward to sharing the data with you guys.
Okay, so we've got 20 models involved. Let's get started. Let's get talking drivers. We get a number of comments about why don't you include dispersion data in the numbers that we show. It wasn't really until we spoke to Alan Hocknall, who's the head of R&D at Callaway, and he mentioned about how the Mavrik has got really good spin robustness, which basically means that it counteracts your differences between your highest and your lowest spinning shots, and from left to right as well. That we thought, well, as part of this test, let's see if Flash Face is actually doing what it's meant to do. And we were pretty impressed, Neil.
Yeah, certainly was. And like I say, Sam, I think while we do this here with drop-off data in ball speed, side and backspin carry, it gives us a lot more of an accurate reading.
Yeah. So just to explain, we've basically taken all of the drop-offs in ball speed from the fastest to the slowest with each driver. We've also taken the side and the backspin, so your left to right, top to bottom, of each driver, and combine them into one number here. And then we've also taken the carry distance, so you drop off between your longest and your shortest shots with each driver and put them over here. And the results make pretty interesting reading.
They certainly do. The one that strikes me straight away, Simon, is the Callaway-Mavrik here, the side and backspin drop off. 708 there, you can see, but this is the one here, 32% better than the
driver. Down to number two here, okay.
And better than second place. That's a huge... That proves how forgiving it actually is, doesn't it? Mm-hmm.
So just to make everyone aware, that Callaway say that the Mavrik has got an MOI lower than what the Epic Flash was, but the forgiveness is 12 to 13% better. And that's a difficult number to be able to get your head around. Mm-hmm. The MOI goes down, but your forgiveness goes up. Just tell us about the carry distance as well, because that's
again,
pretty good.
So we got, well, number one again, the Mavrik for this. Five yards drop off. Again, 55% better than the one that was in at number two in the Mizuno. So for those two categories there, the Mavericks is, well, it's a serious bit of kit, a very good driver. And the technology that they've put in there, Simon, is obviously backed up by the data we've produced.
Okay. And the other numbers that really stand out on this chart for us are the Ping G410 Plus, because we all know that Ping makes some very forgiving drivers. And it's very difficult to be able to prove that when you look at dispersion numbers, because if you hit one shot that's 20 yards left, the one shot that's 20 yards right, you get an average of zero, which is very, very misleading. Yeah. On this chart, they're actually very, very tight across...
To be in the top two and three for every category, really, that is a fantastic achievement. And don't forget, this is last year's model that's still current, isn't it? So there's no doubt that they'll have something maybe in the pipeline for the end of this year. But like we've discussed before, Ping G410 Plus driver, very forgiving. You still pick up a little bit of ball speed on there with your miss hits. And the data, just like the Mavrik, the data backs that statement up.
Okay, and also that 12 yards at the end, that's pretty much what you would expect to see between your best and your worst drives.
Yeah, I'd say that. Yeah, 12, 13, 14 yards, definitely. Yeah, it's a good number.
Okay, that's a great place to start. There's also every single brand that is talking about aerodynamics and speed. So we thought it would be a really good idea to see which club heads are fastest and why. Let's move on, Neil. All of the major launches for this year all speak about aerodynamics. So it made perfect sense for us to just have a look into what club head speeds Neil was creating with each model, just to see if we could find out if the aerodynamic models are actually any faster. So just looking at the chart here, we've got 4 miles an hour difference between the top and the bottom. That's pretty significant, Neil.
Certainly is, yeah. And again, the data is matching with what we were kind of predicting, isn't it? Mm. The Wilson D7 being the lightest club, we said
it's
we were
very,
gonna,
very lightweight driver.
Yeah, that we said we were going to swing the fastest. I have, so there was no surprise there. But the big thing that strikes me, the two brands that have come to the table this year working on aerodynamics, Callaway-Mavrik and TaylorMade-SIM-Max, are both up on the test average of 107 there. You can see the Mavrik's got a 1.2% gain and the TaylorMade-SIM a 0.75% gain. Again, it's only minuscule of a gain, but it's still a gain. It's still a little bit more aerodynamic than our average test.
And just bear in mind, we've taken this data from every single shot that Neil has hit. Mm. We weren't able to get a couple of data for a few of the drivers down here, but it's averaged out across all of those shots. And when you look at the test average, which is around about here, everything there is above average, which has got to say that those clubs are really performing aerodynamically much more so than these down here. And it's probably worthwhile at this point just pointing out that on the PXG, the 0811XF, that wasn't set up to your spec, Neil, it was set up to mine. So it's really unfair to be comparing that against the top speed drivers.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But that's loads there about aerodynamics. Let's move on and have a look at the whole data set. Right, the bit that everybody's been waiting for and the piece that everybody wants to know about. How do all of these top drivers actually compare to each other? Well, Neil, just give us a rundown.
Yeah, so as you can see here, the first thing I want to pick up on, the Epic Flash Sub-Zero, number one for carry, 280. But do not get misled with this being the best driver for me because I've carried it 280 yards, because we've discussed before and we've proven it that it's not. The weight's forward.
So you get more ball speed.
Correct.
You get more distance.
And then I feel, and I still believe that when I do miss hit it, and it's just a difficult club for me to perform well.
Okay, and just to show you as well, we've literally got 3 yards between the top five drivers. You know, if you carried on testing, carried on testing, carried on testing, that might well switch around a little
definitely.
Bit. We've got 2 yards between the top three. Mm. You know, which is
very
which
tight,
is very,
isn't
very
it?
Tight.
Yeah, definitely. But Callaway-Mavrik there again. Look,
up here.
Third place. Mm-hmm. So not only have they done well on the previous, the drop-off data, they've actually, it's long as well.
Really, really powerful.
But one thing I do want to mention and touch upon, Simon, is the SIM-Max. Now, as we know, SIM-Max normally would come with the Ventus shaft.
Yeah, as a standard stock
shaft. We switched that around.
Yeah, so in a previous video, we showed you some data about the SIM-Driver, and we'd only actually tested the driver at that point using the stock shaft.
Yeah.
But what have we found when we switched them over?
Yeah, so when I've switched them around, we found that the Ventus isn't really a great fit for me. So when we did switch that around and tried the hazardous, look how far it's jumped up, straight up into like third place.
So you've jumped up an extra 6 yards.
Which is huge, isn't it, really? If we could all gain 6 yards, then it's definitely, you're going in with half a club less to each green, aren't you?
Okay. And another stat that is really important to you is that we've got 16 yards of difference between our shortest driver and our longest driver, which is maybe a club and a half for some people.
Well, that is huge. That is a big number. So this is really why it is important to get that right fit and don't be obsessed with distance. Do you know what I mean? You really have got to get the right fit.
So last year, we really felt that there was 4 top drivers on the market, and they were the Ping G410 Plus, the Callaway Epic Flash,
yep.
the TaylorMade M6 and also the Cobra F9. We probably feel that this year that's changed a little bit more because when you look at the Cobras, they're nowhere near
The new model hasn't quite performed like we were expecting, really, has it, Simon? For me, this year, the big ones, it would be the Callaway-Mavrik, the TaylorMade, the Sim Max, and you cannot leave out that Ping G410, just for how forgiving it is. Like we said, in the drop-off data, they were in the top three for every category.
Okay. And the other driver that you've got to put in that top four this year, if there is a top four, is that Mizuno ST200.
Yeah, fast, isn't it?
Last year, we really felt that they weren't that forgiving, whereas this year, they've really stepped that up. Mm. It's fast, it's long, and it's pretty forgiving as well.
Yeah. Like you say, it's up there, right in second place there. And Mizuno, I haven't really been known for making fantastic drives in the past. I reckon this could be a good year for Mizuno drivers.
Okay, that's all of our data, but it's not quite the end of the story, because Ping have got some exciting news for you this year. Let's have a look at it. Every new driver that's launched nowadays, it comes with a promise of high launch, low spin. And what that's basically led to is that golfers just chase low spin, high launch. And Ping have been doing lots and lots of research into this of late. And what they've actually found is that there's no point in just chasing high launch, low spin for all golfers. It just does not work. What's really, really important is to optimize for your own game. So everyone will have their own optimal launch and spin numbers to be able to hit their ultimate distance with their driver that you're going to get fitted for this year. And potentially, if you look at your attack angle and your speed on this chart and find your optimal numbers, there's a very good chance that you'll gain more yards than just going out and buying a new driver based on the data we've already shown you behind. So if we've gone over the data a little too quickly for you and you've not been able to digest it, then all of the data behind me and all of the data on this chart is available on our website. We'll leave a link in our bio so you can find it very easily. But please take the time just to go and have a look and mull over the numbers, try and establish which might be your favorite or best fitting driver of 2020. We've created all of this data inside using a Foresight GC Quad launch monitor. And that basically means that we can use a premium golf ball, so all of the data is very, very comparable. A number of the shots that you've seen are actually outside with the door up here, and that basically means that the video looks a little bit better. If once you've gone and had a look at our website and you've looked at the data, if you've still got any comments or questions, please leave them below and we promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.